Now, an update on the situation in the Gulf from ITN's Richard Barth.